this is Prometheus giving you another Draft Championship Live gameplay, going with the Cleveland playbook on offense. I form twins, strong close, and the gun doubles is my primary offenses, and I'll probably jump in the wide trips, halfback weak, and the shotgun bunch occasionally. I've been having pretty good success against my opponents with these particular schemes, especially with the 34 bear. That's actually been giving me very good pressure with the way my team is designed. This is going to be, as you can see right here, I'm 5-1, so this is my Draft Championship game. Let's see if I can pull off a Draft Championship game and get myself one underneath my belt. All right, so we're going to go against Cold Turkey, 2388. He's got the Falcons. I've got the Buccaneers. So cool name, Cold Turkey, 2388. And for the final time, I'm actually going to be receiving the ball again in the series. It's been a lot of this particular gameplays in this Cleveland series that I've been receiving the ball when the game first starts. He does a high kick and able to go ahead and get the ball up to the 35, so I'll take it. All right, so base play, once again, is going to be the I-form twins. I'm going to go ahead and show them the fullback dive, make them respect that. And it looks like he's got... I ran right into his defender right there. His guy just came off clean off my block, so that's not a good way to start that. Let's see what type of defense he was in. So he was in a nickel, and he was under smoke. So I'm just going to assume that he's probably going to try to come out into that again. Do the quick toss off the left-hand side. Off coverage. Nope, this time he actually goes ahead and goes into zone coverage. So he mixes up. He didn't stay with the same coverage at all, but third and inches right here. And I'm not going to feel too confident with my running game based on what he's doing. But let's just go ahead and see if he's got some kind of, let's see if he's got QB sneak defense. There you go. So easy first down with the QB sneak. All right, so let's go back into I form. Once again, we're going to go ahead and hit him with the fullback dive. Let's take a look at his alignment. This time, I think I'm going to get the blocking off the left. No, what? Why is that? Why is that guard actually picking up the center? That's not supposed to happen like that. So you want it under smoke again on first down. Let's go into gun doubles, and we're going to do tight end slot. And he wanted the zone last time, so let's hit him with a mid draw. So he's got backed off coverage. There you go. Able to pick us some pretty good yards, but I wasn't able to get past those two defenders right there. So his defense plays a little bit better than his play selection. I haven't seen anything out of his play selection that's been outstanding at all. Trey open here. I got to pick a play right here. I'm going to go right into the verticals and hopefully I can get this off. There you go. He brought in the corner came in on a blitz. Was that a corner blitz? Yep, he went in the corner blitz. Okay, so I don't know how good this guy is as far as his play selection. Come on. God, he just couldn't get back past that blocker. Had the block. He went under smoke. Says under smoke. He's got a man as his first. He does man as his first play right there. So and then he goes into zone. I think here. I'm gonna go ahead and flip the play. Stay up. There you go. Jerry came out and blocked up that guy. Gave me a little lane to get into. All right, so I'm going to do the full halfback force. I haven't really used this play a lot, but it's a nice little edge run. And if I can get off that tackle, I might be able to pick up some pretty good yards. There you go. That's it. Force play is able to go ahead and make a nice little seal, get the ball in the end zone, burn the entire quarter too with this drive, and just effectively just tore this guy up. So kick the ball deep into the end zone. He's going to be forced to kneel the ball. I'm going to flip my linebackers once again and set up my base blitz, which is going to be the pinch dog three. Didn't set it up. And he catches right over top of my guy right there. Went ahead and played the ball. Unable to go ahead and do that, so he did a shot play against me. Oh. And my defensive back makes a huge play right there. And he takes a timeout. I don't know why he did that. And there's the edge pressure. I finally got the play set up. Once again, pressure off the edge. You had no answer for that. And the pressure off the edge again, he can't get it. So I don't know how good this guy is based on the way he didn't handle that pressure. He didn't get rid of the ball. He didn't look at the flats. And he's been doing some pretty unorthodox plays on defense too, as far as some of the play selection he's had. Nice run defense there right there. Back to the draw again. And I think he is in man. There you go. Watson makes a huge play for me. Let's take this down to the 2-minute warning. I'm going to flip the play and do the toss again. He's got up coverage. He's into a 3D. There you go. All right, so working the clock down. I'm not going to give him any time whatsoever to do anything with his scheme. And I'm going to do the force. To do the backside run here. He's in a wide set, but I think he's offsides. He's not. But I think I picked up a first down. Did not. All right, so I'm tempted to chew the clock a little bit more against this guy. Go ahead and take a timeout right here to preserve the clock. I'm gonna go back into the I-form twins, and I'm gonna hit him with a fullback dive. He's had very good defense against the dive so far, and I don't like the alignment, so we're gonna do a power. We're gonna go off to the left. There you go. Able to get the ball in. It's only left him 15 seconds left, so that means he's going to have to hit me with a lob streak to be able to get that off, and that's not a very good thing for him right now. All right, so he burned about a good 3 seconds to get the ball up to the 23-yard line. He's going to lob streak me, so I need to go ahead and make sure that I've got my best players out there. And why he ran right there, there's no reason to do that. He should have done that play first. He would have been able to pick up some more yards. I don't know why he went into that screen. So up by two scores, I've been chewing the clock with him offensively. It's been basically my offense has just been dominating him, and he's hit me with one lob streak, and then he's struggled with my defense when I've been able to set up my blitz correctly. So able to get the ball up to the 30-yard line. That's a good return. I'm going to stay in the pinch dog three. And the blitz off the edge just killed him. He went into play action. And once again, play action stayed in the same play. So he's going into that play action max protect, and it's just killing him. And that's just a bad throw. He just got rid of the ball. Crazy. There you go. I couldn't just went with another one of those play action comeback routes. So I'm assuming this guy's going to quit out on me. I'm a much better player than him, hands down. He doesn't have a scheme. So this is kind of uneventful for a draft championship to be able to go ahead and get play like this against someone, is that you just really can dominate somebody like this. So let's just roll some more clock off. So another touchdown with the fullback dive, going up by three scores against my opponent. Blitz. This time the blitz gets taken up. He makes a good read right there. All right, so Shields plays really good for me on the backside right there. He's just depending on the lob streaks. Good read. And another bad throw by Fitzpatrick. So he's just getting rid of the ball really quick. I'm going to go into the pinch mic. And he actually threw the guy I was supposed to manually defend, and I just didn't get the ball off quick enough. And the blitz off the edge screwed him up a little bit. There you go. Brooks is just killing this guy underneath. Good read. Good read to stay in the game. Went in a man, just trying to mix things up against this guy. He's starting to break down my defense, so... There we go. So misses a two-point conversion. That's going to come back and haunt him. I wonder if he's going to do an onside kick, which he does. But he touched the ball early, so I'm going to get it at the 38. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and milk this guy right now. I got a chew clock. I'm going to flip the formation out of the huddle. There you go. I'm just going to go ahead and dive, take this clock down into the fourth quarter. And just didn't get the ball off. So I got some yards against me. I'm going to go ahead and take the chew clock off. Got to take this down to the fourth quarter right here. So I've been effectively beating this guy on the ground. I've only thrown four times, and I've had completed all balls against him. So mid-blitz right there. I'm going to try doing the force off to the right-hand side. Let's see if I get the blocking like it did before. Nice little seal right there. Look at a seal with that running with the force. Wow. Just the goal to right here is just to go ahead and chew the clock. Little jag route with the tight end underneath, able to go ahead and pick up a touchdown. Just going to go ahead and take the extra point. And I was able to go ahead and chew up a good 2 minutes off the clock in the process. And there's the Madden love right here, where basically it allows you to get back into these games with bullshit plays like that, with the returns like that. It's just the way this game plays, it just does silly stuff like that. So let's do the pincho. Alright, so gave up another garbage score against this guy. He's gonna go for two again. There you go. Made a play right there. He waited for me to move away, and I was able to go ahead and get the spot route. So if I catch the ball right here, this should be pretty much the game. So you kick deep, and the goal right now is just to get a first down. So let's stay in the strong close. We're going to do tight end option. He's probably going to run commit. There you go. So Jeffrey should be wide open over the top. And the pressure comes off. I was actually going to try to hit Jeffries, and I couldn't do it. He just didn't have enough time. And I gave up a sack on that, so I'm actually moving the clock. There you go. So I'm going to just go ahead and stop this game right here, because I just don't want to keep playing this guy. I just completely have outplayed this guy the entire game, even though I gave up two scores. And we're just going to hurry up. And just went ahead and did a garbage touchdown. That's kind of cheesy of me to do that, but I just decided to go ahead and just do it. All right, so 35-12 against this guy. He really wasn't that good of an opponent. He struggled against the blitz. It wasn't until maybe the second half that he started figuring out how to go ahead and beat it. But I had just pretty much had my way against this guy the entire time. The only reason I didn't score anything in the first quarter was because I had the ball the entire first quarter and just basically was putting up points the entire time. So, you want to play better opponents. You want to have good games, but sometimes you just run in people that are just not as good as you. So not patting myself on the back is just basically had control of this game from the very beginning. But you can see the Cleveland playbook. The gun doubles is a very effective playbook. The I-form twins and strong close. They had the respective run on the inside and the outside. And when you have an effective running game, that really will open up pretty much the rest of your offense. You can see at a very balanced attack with 100 yards on the ground, 120 on top. And this guy didn't really have any kind of an answer to my blitz scheme. I was able to get a lot of pressure against him, forced a lot of four and outs. So to my subscribers, I hope you appreciate this. I'll be rolling out more Madden 17 content. I might do one more scheme out of the Madden 16. But to you guys, I really appreciate your support. Make sure you check out Yutt Gaming. That's a part of the new gaming crew that I'm a part of. You can catch a lot of good content with the guys I'm going to be associating with at Yutt Gaming. So to my subscribers, thanks a lot. Until next time.